Hey, what's up guys? Professor Tom, hope you love this video. Don't forget to hit subscribe and enjoy. Start looking at some more advanced ones going through, all the way through to some leg bars later, okay? So, I am going to borrow Matt to demonstrate. So Matt is on his back, and I'm in 50-50, okay? So we'll just start from 50-50 here, okay? So in this position, you wanna make sure you're holding onto their knee, because you don't want them to retract their leg and get out. And we also wanna make sure that we are falling to the side. So we wanna make sure, regardless of leg locking, that we really, in no gi, I would call this hiding my heel, but in the gi, you think of it like sweeping. So if I put my knees to this side like this, this is now his lower leg, and because I control the lower leg, he can't do a technical stand-up, so he can't get up like this, okay? So from 50-50 in this position, my knees are pinching, and I go to the side like this, okay? Now, one of the ways that you can go for ankle locks from here that I personally like, although I tend not to use it as much these days, is to get the ankle around this way, feet go into the hip, knee squeeze, and then deadlift through, like this. I do really like that approach. However, today we're going to emphasize rolling the ankle this way, almost like a gable grip toe hold. So we're going to emphasize, rather than coming in on the Achilles, we're gonna skip that padding and we're gonna hit right into the bone here, okay? So we're gonna emphasize rolling and then stretching this way, okay? So let's have a look at how we do that. So from this position, I like to hold onto the heel and I like to lift it up, make a little bit of space and then cut my hand around. It's really important that the first bite is an important bite, so get a good bite, okay? So don't just grab it loose, get a good bite. Now, I take my lapel and pass it to my hand, okay? So I like to not pass it this way, I like to turn it and pass it this way. And then I'm making sure that I'm rotating my wrist to get that radius bone nice and tight, okay? So, from this position, I'm here, I get it, I hold it tight, I make sure I'm flapping my wing back, and then watch how I go for my submission, guys. I focus on the turn. Here. Okay, so focusing on the turn really rolls the ankle. I can always extend later. So you imagine I've got him down in this position, I wrap, okay? I grab onto my lapel, I come low on his ankle and flat, okay? I squeeze my knees as tight as I can. I come up, I look over my shoulder, and I'm turning, okay? Which cuts my forearm into the side of that ankle. And then my armpit will take it this way. So that's the fulcrum, that's the end of the lever, and I'm getting that sharp roll, okay? So from 50-50, come under, grab, knees pinching tight. If you do not isolate the knee, this will not work. Flap your elbow back, and then turn, okay? Obviously, if I turn, I can also extend, but you'll often find that the turning is more or less what gets the job done, okay? If you want to take it a little bit further from here this morning, guys, sometimes you'll realize that from this position, guys like Matt will begin to see this arm as an enemy and grab that freaking thing. Okay, because he's like, Tom grabs my right foot with his right arm and does the footlock thing. Okay, so when he grabs that, I can move my hips back and come through with my left arm. Okay, so I used to call this a catapult lock, like on some of my earlier YouTube videos, I called it the catapult lock. Because he was the first person I saw doing it years ago, a black belt. And so you're gonna take your left hand through, and that now forms your fulcrum. He can keep pulling that, and I just grab onto my own bicep, and from here I do the same thing, knee squeeze. I take my right elbow back, I turn the corner, and extend. Okay? So this one is like almost worse than the first one. Right? Yeah, I agree. So I like it. It is still my secondary one. The reason I like to do this one primarily is I feel my body is a bit more in line. It's a little bit less twisted, that's all. So I think this one is a friendlier fulcrum with more power. This one is a much meaner fulcrum, but I'm a little bit more twisted, I feel. So I feel that my power is slightly compromised. Both of them will get the job done. I love them both. The third one, and this is one I started doing, and I always feel guilty doing this. Sometimes I even bite my own knee to pass it. So whenever you grab a gi, you often do like this. I've found myself before biting my lapel and moving it to my hand. Sometimes he grabs that hand and he like, for me, I know a lot of people start to recognize this and they fear me grabbing the bicep. So he'll put his knee inside like this. So like this can happen to me against my training partners. So I like push with my face and I bring my lapel down. So I've got the lapel and now I squeeze my knees and I find it almost even better than the bicep, okay? So this is one you're gonna have to use. I sometimes like bite it and bring it to it, but most of the time I just like push it with my face. Sort of seems weird, it is, but it works really well. So again, this would be my plan A, lapel, knee squeeze, twisting and turning. Plan B is he grabs that hand, I come through, lock onto my bicep, repeat said process. Really emphasizing pulling that elbow back to sharpen the fulcrum. And then number three is this dude's smart and from here it doesn't really work. So you like just grab your own lapel, tighten it up into his Achilles here, turn and extend, right? Sorry, man. It's very, very tight, okay? Next, we'll start to talk about what happens when the guy decides to triangle his legs off like this, okay? So just in summary, I'm here in 50-50. If my knees face out, I control who gets on top. If I was like a boring IBJJF guy, I would just do here and squeeze. There's so many IBJJF matches I could have won if I just did this, but I always don't. I always go for the foot lock because it's more fun, I guess. It's probably not the best. If you're a competitor, you may want to invest time just winning by stalling like this. But I personally think jiu-jitsu is all about submissions and I don't care about losing. I'd rather have more victories by submission than victories by points. So from here, plan A, squeeze my knees, up on my elbow, turning, okay? Plan B, grabs my hand, clever bugger. I grab onto my own bicep, come back, same thing, finishing the same. Plan C, smart bugger, face, lapel, squeeze, okay? I really like this one. Obviously it depends on the gi, but so too does his ability to grab my hand well. So I find it's fine. The problem is in the gi, the solution is also in the gi. So this is really good, guys. I think footlocks work so well. One of the reasons that they don't work sometimes so well is that people can get out of this and they expect it, right? Whereas in 50-50, it's a lot easier to get into. But from this position, we can really do some serious damage, okay? Like in terms of breaking feet, I think this position is better, okay? Let's practice it. This is completely white belt legal, so enjoy. Let's go. If you get a perfect quality footlock, if you follow the best recipe with the best ingredients, I bet you make tasty food. Like I bet if you broke into a Michelin star restaurant, you stole all their ingredients, you got the Michelin star chef to write you out the perfect recipe, I bet all of us, even hopeless cooks like me, could make for a very good meal. Okay, so let's now have a look at what we do. We've got our perfect good quality footlocks. Now let's have a look at what to do when they triangle their legs off. So this happens gi and no gi. There's two skills that we're teaching here. One is how to unlock their legs. The second one is how to finish with a leg bar. Okay, so these are both skills that you want to learn. I'm actually going to address both a white belt legal attack and a colored belt legal attack, okay, so you guys can really understand both. So I'm going to borrow Matt, and he's going to be on his back. We're going to be in 50-50. So there's a multitude of ways that we can end up in 50-50, but whether I'm doing gi or no gi, sometimes Matt's gonna triangle his legs off, okay? And so he's here like this, and I'm dealing with triangle off legs, all right? So there's a number of ways I can get these undone, okay? I'm just going to show you like a way that I like to do when I'm doing the attack as a white belt, okay? If I need to not be able to attack leg bars. So in IBJJF, this would be purple belt and below. I can come underneath here, grab the toes, and I pry his foot off. So I like to do this another way if I can do leg bars, but as a white belt, I like to take my right hand out and grab onto the toes, and then I'm prying with my arm this way to push his foot off. So I now move my whole body and I pry his leg off. So it's just like this, Matt can hold quite tight, I've got my hand on the toes, and then I pry with my elbow to get that off, okay? If I was in no-gi, I can look at going for my heel hooks and stuff like that. But for today, we're gonna have a look at IBJJF legal stuff. So for the white belt, you're actually gonna now attack this foot, okay? So if he re-triangles up, I come here, I pry him apart, I scoop onto this leg, and this is really important, especially once you start to do heel hooks and stuff like this. This is a real vulnerable foot here, so I need to put my knee underneath so he can't get me in a heel hook come summer no gi time. So from this position, guys, here, I can grab my lapel just like before, okay? And now, if you lock the far leg under IBJJF, white to black belt, you need to always fall to the side that the leg is being attacked on. So this is Matt's left leg, so I need to make him fall to his left side. So watch what I'm gonna do, guys. I've got my knee out, I've got my tight grip. I'm gonna go down to my right delt, throw my left hand, and throw my left leg. So I'm gonna aim far on the mats like this, okay? And I've brought my hips down low. So this leg can be far, this hand can be far. I keep this shoulder and head heavy, and then I sink my hips in, and I'm gonna get a real easy tap, okay? So the key of this is to really take your body over and control the knee. In any foot lock, it's all about controlling the knee. See, imagine I'm trying to foot lock in here. If his knee can come up, right, the foot lock would never come on. But if that knee was in a vice, then he'd feel every bit of pressure that I put through here. So that's the key we've got to do tonight, guys. We got to put that knee on the mat and really put our hips through it. So here I am in 50-50. Most people are just worried about this leg. But whether it's toe holds, foot locks, leg bars, we want to have a diverse attack series from here, gi or no gi. Most people are only worried about the toe hold here, like this, okay? And that's certainly a tremendous attack. We've covered that before. But for today, you can keep your legs crossed, reach under, grab the toes, pry off. Now I get this tight, elbow to the ground, I get my lapel if I'm in the gi, and now I'm going to get my knee out. This is super important that I get my knee out, okay? Now my left hand and left leg are gonna fly over. So my left leg will end up over there, my left hand will end up over there, and I'm gonna be squishing the heck out of his foot up here, and I'll be squishing the heck out of his knee with my hips. So I come over here, and now just go down. You won't need much pressure at all, guys. As long as you've got a tight bite, you've got all the pressure you need in the world here. You don't really need much extension at all. Just the teeniest bit of body movement to get the tap. So just one last time on this foot lock here. I reach under, I pry his feet apart, okay? You'd have the heel hook here in no gi, but we're in the gi today. So I'm gonna get that foot and get my knee out, okay? I get the tight bite on the lapel. And now I'm gonna go down to this shoulder as my left hand and left leg come over. And now slowly hips down for a very easy tap. Just make sure you support a bit of your body weight. If you're not in competition, you know, so you don't hurt people. So practice that one. That's a tremendous attack. And then next, we're gonna have a look at how to go from that position into one of my favorite leg bars with a slightly different leg weave. And one of the leg bars I've used a lot, I really enjoy it. I hope you do too. But let's first practice the far side foot lock, belly down in 50-50. Quite rare, but feel it. It's bloody strong. Okay, let's go.
Hey guys, hope you love the video. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and don't forget you can check out thegrapplingacademy.com for more courses. Have fun on the mats. Happy rolling.